Hey guys, it's Giselle and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be talking about how I stay organized using my planner and also how I decorate it as well. So this planner in particular that I use is the 2015 Sugar Paper for Target planner. It was a little bit challenging to find, so I'm really glad that I was able to get my hands on them. I absolutely love this size planner. It's not too big that I feel like I can't take it places, but it's not too small that I feel like I can't write in it. I am a huge firm believer in customizing things to be how you want it, to think outside of the box for how you would like to see it and view it and use it, because if you don't like how it is, then you're not going to use it. So you're going to see the way that I organize my planner is a little bit different than how normal people organize their planners, because that's just the way that I like it. So anyway, when you first open my planner, I just have a little color-coded key right here. I like to color code things when I put them in my planner because I feel like it just makes me more organized and I'm able to visually see, okay, on this day I have this and on this day I have this. I'm just able to visually kind of immediately see what's going on just by the color that's on it. So when you go to a monthly view, because then afterwards it's just like random like contact pages and stuff like that. So when you go to a monthly view, this is where the customization is going to be a little bit different than most people. I like my planners to be, my monthly views to start on Monday. I know that's really weird, but I want to say probably like 90% of planners out there all start on Sundays and then their weekly views start on Monday. So it's really odd to me that they don't reflect each other, that they're kind of opposite in that way. So I like my monthly views to start on Monday and my weekly views to also start on Monday as well, just so that they go in like hand in hand. And honestly, I use my monthly views so much more than my like daily views. I can't even tell you how much more than I use it, but I use my daily views for something else and I'll get into that. But I really just use whiteout, and I will white out all of the dates and the days, and then I will just rewrite all the days and dates in, and I'll just bump it up a day so that it starts on a Monday, because that's the way that I personally like to see planners. I like to see them start on Mondays and not Sundays. That's just me. So then when you go into daily views, another weird thing that I do is that I don't use my daily views in the typical way. I really like to think positive, and I wanted to start a gratitude journal. So I had started a gratitude journal back in December, and I just would write down like the days. It was literally like a little diary for me. I would write down the days and I would write down a couple of things I was thankful for the day. So what I decided to do was I started using my daily views as my gratitude journal, because they're already dated and they already have lines and spaces for it. So every day I just write down a couple of things that I am thankful for the day. It could be one thing, it could be five things, it can be nothing. Like I could just say, oh, like my boyfriend came to town. So like, it's just a couple of things that I'm thankful for the day. It's just, to me, it's a really good reminder that just because you're having a bad day doesn't mean that it's an actual bad day. There's always something good in every day. So it's just a reminder to kind of remember that and know that there's always something good and positive that's going on regardless of how you feel. So not saying that I'm a negative person, because I don't think I'm a negative person, but it's just a really good reminder. So that's what I use my daily views for, and I know that's really odd and kind of out of the box, but that's what I use my daily views for. So I'm going to show you right now how I am going to be decorating the month of March. So then when you get to the back of my planner, I just have a couple of line pages that I just put video ideas for YouTube. And then on the very, very back, I keep some blank pages that I can just jot things down, a to-do list or anything like that. And then I actually just stick on some post-it notes so I have them on hand if I needed to use them for anything. I typically use post-it notes for like a reminder of my bills right there, so I'll stick it on over there, but I like to just have them in case I need them for anything else. So that was everything on how I stay organized using my planner. I honestly just want you guys to take away from this that having a planner is just paper. And you can organize it and customize it however you like. So be creative and think outside the box because it's yours. So I hope you guys like this video. Make sure you subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already so you don't miss out on any other videos from me. I hope you guys are having an awesome day and I will see you in my next one. Bye! The most interesting because of the size of it. It's not the typical notebook size. It's a little bit fatter and chunkier, if that makes sense. It's like almost the size of my hand. So I thought it was interesting just because of the size of it. I haven't seen